Good morning all. Today we discuss the free particle solution for Dirac relativistic wave equation. We know the Dirac relativistic wave equation for a free particle. For a free particle we can write the Dirac relativistic wave equation as E psi RT is equal to C. Dirac Hamiltonian is given by C alpha dot P operating on wave function psi RT plus beta m C square psi RT. Taking all the terms to left hand side, we can write it as E minus C alpha dot P E psi minus C alpha dot P psi RT minus beta m c square psi rt is equal to 0. So this is Dirac relativistic wave equation where no term involving potential is present. So this equation represents the Dirac relativistic wave equation for a free particle. Now we will find the solution for this equation. We know that the alpha and beta are matrices. What is the dimension of that matrix? Alpha is a 4 by 4 matrix. Beta is also a 4 by 4 matrix. Since they are matrices of dimension 4 by 4, we should have 4 components for wave function psi rt. So, in this case, the psi rt should have 4 components. So, it should be represented by a column vector. It should be represented by 4 components. It is having 4 rows and 1 column. Each component we can take it as psi 1 RT, first component, second component psi 2 RT, third component psi 3 RT, and the fourth component psi 4 RT. So we will be getting 4 solutions. This equation is equivalent to 4 homogeneous first order partial differential equation. P is first order, I h bar minus I h bar del, and E is I h bar dou by dou t. So this equation is a first order differential equation and we will be having 4 components. So this represents four first order homogeneous differential equations. So that 4 components are given by psi 1, psi 2, psi 3 and psi 4. Now we assume plane wave solution for this each component. So this psi 1, psi 2, psi 3, psi 4, I am writing it as psi j rt, where j equal to 1, 2, 3 and 4. The plane wave solution of each equation given by equation 1 can be written as plane wave solution can be written as psi j rt equal to uj e raised to I k dot r minus omega j. The plane wave solution we are writing it as psi j rt equal to uj e raised to I k dot r minus omega j, where uj is a number which is having 4 components, just like psi 1, psi 2, psi 3, psi 4. Uj, it will be having 4 components, u1, u2, u3, u4. So uj, j equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. So u1, u2, u3, u4. So psi 1 will be u1 e raised to I k dot r minus omega t. Psi 2 will be u2 e raised to I k dot r minus omega t, and so on. Now, this E psi is equivalent to E is I h bar dou by dou t. Operator E is equivalent to I h bar dou by dou t. So E psi is I h bar dou by dou t of psi. Psi we can write it as E psi j is I h bar dou by dou t, psi j is uj e raised to I k dot r minus omega j. So uj is a number, we can take it outside. Then dou by dou t of e raised to I k dot r minus omega t will be I h bar uj into minus I omega e raised to I k dot r minus omega t. This I square minus plus, then it will be h bar omega. Omega is constant. So it is h bar omega uj e raised to I k dot r minus omega t. H bar omega is the energy eigenvalue. I am writing E equal to H bar omega. This is operator E and this one is energy eigenvalue. H bar omega is energy eigenvalue E. So I can write this equation as operator E operating on psi j yields E uj e raised to I k dot r minus omega t. Now find the operation of p with the psi rt. P psi j. P operating on psi j. So p is minus I h bar del. Minus I h bar del operating on psi j uj e raised to I k dot r minus omega. For simplicity, if I take k along x direction, then it will be I k x minus omega t. So del will be dou by dou x. If it is along x direction, then the component along x direction will be dou by, component of del along x direction will be dou by dou x. Dou by dou x of this one will be minus I h bar uj e raised to I kx minus omega t into ik dou by dou x. So it will be ik. Coefficient of x is ik. So it will be I h bar into ik. Then I square minus this minus plus. So plus h bar k. This will be h bar k uj e raised to I kx minus omega t. H bar k is momentum eigenvalue. So this p, I am taking it as p, where p is h bar k, it is momentum eigenvalue. Energy eigenvalue h bar omega and momentum eigenvalue h bar k. So instead of h bar k, I can write it as p. So it will be p uj e raised to I kx minus omega t. In general, I am writing k dot r, kx instead of k dot r. If it is along any arbitrary direction, we can write kx as k dot r. So pj psi j, pj psi j will be, pj psi j will be p into uj e raised to I k dot r minus omega, where e is eigenvalue, energy eigenvalue. So it is independent of r and t. P is momentum eigenvalue, not operator, which is independent of r and t. Now substitute these values in equation 1. So equation 1 becomes, instead of Vj, E psi j, E psi rt, we can write it as eigenvalue E uj e raised to I k dot r minus omega t. I can write it common. All into E raised to I k dot r minus omega t is equal to 0. So first time uj, then minus C alpha dot, it will be P uj. P uj, p uj e raised to I k dot r minus omega t. Then minus beta mc square uj e raised to I k dot r minus omega t. So here E is energy eigenvalue, P is momentum eigenvalue, and alpha and beta, we already discussed earlier, alpha and beta are independent of R and P. They are independent of E and P. E, alpha and beta are independent of R, G, E and P. Also, since they are independent of E, no term containing dou by dou t is there in alpha and beta, and no term containing dou by dou x or dou by dou y. Derivative with respect to space is contained in alpha and beta. So we can take e raised to I k dot r minus omega t common, because here no term is there which is an operator which contain r t dou by dou t over that. That means we can this term into e raised to I k dot r minus omega t equal to 0 means we can equate this term to 0. This should be equal to 0. Now Uj is having 4 components. What are they? Uj equal to u1, u2, u3, u4. So these are the 4 components of Uj. Now alpha, we know alpha dot p, we can calculate alpha dot p equal to alpha x p x plus alpha y p y plus alpha z p z. Alpha x is 0, 0, 0, 0. It is 0 sigma x. Sigma x is 0, 1, 1, 0. Then 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Alpha x is 0, sigma x, 0 into px. Plus alpha y is, what is alpha y? 0. Sigma y 0, 0, submatrix, 2 by 2 matrix, 0, sigma y is 0 minus I, 0, then 0 minus I, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, into py, plus sigma 0, sigma z, sigma z 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, sigma z is 1, 0, 0, minus 1, 1, 0, 0, minus 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, into pz. Now multiply this px, multiply this with the px. So here, multiplying this with the px, we'll be getting px here px, px, px. So this one is alpha x px. Now multiply this with py, so it is minus I py here, minus I py, then I py here, minus I py, I py. Now multiply this one with the pz. Pz, so this is pz minus pz, pz minus pz. Now add these three matrices. So in adding these matrices, we will be getting first submatrix, all the elements are 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Second submatrix, we are getting 0, 0, pz. So here we are having pz. Then px minus ipy. Next term is px minus ipy. Px minus ipy. Now this one px plus ipy. Here it is px plus ipy. Then this term is minus pz. Minus pz. Then this one 0, 0, pz. This is pz. Then px minus ipy. Px minus ipy. Then this is px plus ipy. Px plus ipy. 0, 0, minus pz. Minus pz. 0, 0, 0. This is the matrix alpha dot p. Alpha dot p, then multiply this by c. So So all the terms C will be there. For simplicity, I am writing P plus S Px plus Ipy and P minus S Px minus Ip. For my convenience, I am taking Px plus Ipy as P plus and Px minus Ipy as P minus. So this term will be alpha dot P. We can write it as alpha dot P will be 0, 0, P is at P minus 0, 0, P plus minus P is at P is at P minus, then P plus minus P is at 0, 0, 0, 0. Now what is C into alpha dot P? Here on C will come C P minus C P C P Z C P minus C P plus minus C P Z C P Z C P minus C P plus minus C P Z. This is C alpha dot P. Then we can substitute C into alpha dot P. Instead of this one, we can substitute this matrix. Then what is beta? Beta is I 0, 0, minus I. So it is 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, minus 1, 0, 0, minus. First submatrix is 1. This one is 0. Here 0. This is minus 1. Beta is I 0, 0, minus I. So this is beta. For beta, we can substitute this value. I already told uj is having four components. u1, u2, u3, u4. Substituting these values in equation, I can take this as equation 2. Substituting these values in equation 2, we can write it as E into uj. So E into uj is u1, u2, u3, u4 plus minus C alpha dot P uj. C alpha dot P is 0, 0, C P is at C P minus 0, 0, C P plus minus C P Z, then C P Z C P minus 0, 0, C P plus, then minus C P Z 0, 0 into UJ. UJ is U1, U2, U3, U4. Now minus beta mc square. This is beta. Then what is mc square into beta? Here on mc square will come. mc square, minus mc square, minus mc square. This is beta mc square. So beta mc square, we can write it as mc square 0, 0, 0. 0 mc square 0, 0, 0, 0, minus mc square 0, 0, 0, 0, minus mc square. This is beta mc square into uj. Uj is u1, u2, u3, u4. This is equal to 0. Now simplify this. E into u1, u2, u3, u4. That we can write it as E u1, E u2, E u3, E u4. First matrix is this one. Then multiply this with this one. Minus of multiplying this with this one. U3. C P Z U3. C P Z u3 plus cp minus u4. First element will be zpz u3 plus cp minus u4. Now second row is cp plus u3 minus cpz u4. Now the third row will be cpz u1 plus cp minus u2. Fourth row will be cp plus u1 minus cpz u2. This is second matrix. Now minus, multiply this with this one. First element will be mc square u1. Then second element will be mc square u2. Third will be minus mc square u3. Fourth will be minus mc square u4. This is equal to 0. Now simplify that three matrices. On simplifying these three matrices, first term will be E u1 minus of CPZ u3 minus CP minus u4 minus MC square u1 is equal to 0. Second one, E u2 minus CP plus u3 minus minus plus CPZ u4 minus MC square u2 equal to 0. Third equation is E u3 minus CPZ u1 minus CP minus u2 minus minus plus plus mc square u3 is equal to 0. Fourth equation is e u4 minus cp plus u1 minus minus plus cpz u2 plus mc square u4 equal to 0. This first equation we can write it as E u1 minus mc square u1. So I am writing here E minus mc square u1. E minus mc square u1. It is coefficient of u1. Then u2 is not there. Then u3 minus cpz u3 minus cp minus u4 equal to 0. This I am taking it as equation 3.A. That equation is taken as equation 3.A. Now the second equation u2, u1 is absent there, u2, e u2 minus mc square u2. So it will be e minus mc square u2, u3 minus cp plus u3. Cp plus u3 plus c pz u4 plus c pz u4 equal to 0. This is 3.B, equation 3.B. Now the third equation, u3 plus mc square u1. U1 term is minus c pz u1. Now u2 is minus cp minus u2. Then u3 is plus e plus mc square u3 is equal to 0. This is 3.C, equation 3.C. Last equation is minus C p plus u1 plus c pz u2 u3 is absent, fourth term is plus e plus mc square u4 equal to 0. This is equation 3 point D. This equation 3 is having non-trivial solution only when the coefficient of u1, u2, u3, u4, that coefficient matrix, the determinant of that coefficient matrix should be equal to 0. When we write that equation in matrix form, this equation 3 can be represented in matrix form as e minus mc square, e minus mc square, coefficient of u1, now coefficient of u2 is 0, u3 is minus c pz, u4 is minus c p minus. Second equation is coefficient of u1 is 0, coefficient of u2 is e minus mc square, u3 is minus c p plus, coefficient of u4 is c p z. Now the third equation, coefficient of u1 is minus c p z, u2 is minus c p minus, u3 is e plus mc square, then u4 is 0, coefficient of u4 is 0. Taking the fourth equation, coefficient of u1 is minus c p plus, u2 is c p z, u3 is 0, u4 is e plus mc square into this equation. These four components of equation 3 can be represented in matrix form as this one, u1, u2, u3, u4. This should be equal to 0. So this equation is having non-zero value for u1, u2, u3, u4 only when the determinant of this coefficient matrix should be equal to 0. So we can write it as the coefficient matrix, its determinant, that should be equal to 0 for getting non-zero value for u1, u2, u3 and u4. Now find the determinant of this equation, expand this and find this determinant, and that should be equal to 0. When you find the determinant of this equation, you will get it as e square minus p square c square minus m square c raised to 4 the whole square. This, the determinant of this coefficient matrix can be determined as e square minus p square c square minus m square c raised to 4 the whole square. That determinant should be equal to 0. This is equal to 0. This equal to 0 means, this term is equal to 0 means e square minus p square c square minus m square c raised to 4 equal to 0. Or e square equal to p square c square plus m square c raised to 4. Or we can write e as p square c square plus m square c raised to 4 the whole raised to 1 by 2. Since we are taking square root, we can take plus or minus. So we will be having two eigenvalues for energy. One is p square c square plus m square c raised to 4 the whole raised to 1 by 2. Another one is minus of p square c square plus m square c raised to 4 the whole raised to 1 by 2. So we can take the positive eigenvalue. I am representing it as e plus. E plus we can take it as plus p square c square plus m square c raised to 4 the whole raised to 1 by 2. I am writing the minus energy eigenvalue as, negative value as, minus of p square c square plus m square c raised to 4 the whole raised to 1 by 2. So we are having two energy eigenvalues, e plus and e minus. E plus gives positive value and E minus gives negative value. In non-relativistic limit, when P tends to 0, P is very less, or P square C square very very less than M square C raised to 4, then this will be a huge term. If P tends to 0, then this will be a huge term, so we can neglect this term in comparison to this one. So it will be M square C raised to 4 the whole raised to 1 by 2, so it will be M C square. So in non-relativistic limit, this positive energy eigenvalue, this E plus, that becomes plus M C square. Now E minus, if PC is neglected in comparison to M square C raised to 4, P square C square is neglected, then it is M square C raised to 4 the whole raised to 1 by 2, M C square, negative sign is there. So E minus is approximately equal to minus M C square. So we are having two energy eigenvalues, positive E plus and E minus, and we are having four equations. These four equations, two equations corresponds to positive energy eigenvalue and two equations correspond to negative energy eigenvalue. When we take positive energy eigenvalue, if we consider E plus, when we consider E plus in non-relativistic limit, E plus approximately equal to plus mc square. So when I take this one, E plus approximately equal to mc square, this term becomes zero. So this equation is not significant for positive energy eigenvalue. This also E minus mc square becomes zero in non-relativistic limit, low velocity, if the particle is moving with a very small p, then this term becomes zero. So these two equations are not relevant in the case of positive energy eigenvalue. So positive energy eigenvalue, we will be taking the equations 3c and 3d, where when E equal to approximately equal to mc square, this term is not equal to 0 and this one is also not equal to 0. So we will be taking positive energy eigenvalues for two equations 3c and 3d, and these two equations are not relevant for positive energy eigenvalue. When we take negative energy eigenvalue, E minus is approximately equal to minus mc square when p tends to 0. That means these two equations, they are not significant, not relevant when we take E equal to minus mc square, because this term becomes 0. So we will be having diverging values for U3 and U4. Since this term becomes 0, U3 tends to infinity, U4 also tends to infinity. For positive energy eigenvalue, this term becomes 0, that means U1 tends to infinity, U2 tends to infinity. So diverging solutions we are getting for positive energy eigenvalue for these two equations. So for positive energy eigenvalue, we will be taking 3z and 3d. For negative energy eigenvalues, we will be taking 3a and 3b. First we consider the positive energy eigenvalue, E plus. So for positive energy eigenvalue, we are taking equation 3c and 3d, and we are assuming that, for simplicity, we assume that let U1 equal to 1 and U2 equal to 0. We need to determine four parameters, U1, U2, U3 and U4. For positive energy eigenvalue, we are having only two equations, 3z and 3d. So we are assuming that U1 equal to 1 and U2 equal to 0, and correspondingly we will calculate U3 and U4 from equations 3c and 3d. From equation 3c, take this equation, minus c p z U1 is 1 into 1 minus second time U2 is 0, second time becomes 0, minus 0. Then the third time plus E plus mc square. This is positive energy eigenvalue. E plus mc square, U3 equal to 0. From that we can calculate U3 as U3 equal to CPZ by E plus mc square. So we are having U3 as when u1 equal to 0, u2 equal to 0, we will be getting u3 as c, p z by e plus plus mc square. And equation 3d becomes, 3d, minus cp plus u1, u1 is 1, plus u2 is 0, this term is 0, plus e plus mc square u4 is equal to 0. From that we can calculate u4 as u4 equal to cp plus by e plus mc square. For our convenience, px plus ipy is written as p plus. So we can write it as cpx plus ipy by e plus mc square. So we will be having four values. We can write that as first solution as 1, 0, u1, 1, u2, 0. This is components of uj. 1, 0, u3 is cpz by e plus mc square. u4 is cpx plus ipy by e plus mc square. So these are the four components of u for positive energy eigenvalue. So one situation we have taken, u1 equal to 1, u2 equal to 0. In a similar way, for positive energy eigenvalue e plus, we can take u1 equal to 0 and u2 equal to 1. Take u1 equal to 0, u2 equal to 1. u1 equal to 0, u2 equal to 1 for positive energy eigenvalue. This is also for positive energy eigenvalue. u1 1, u2 0. Take equation 3c. Equation 3c becomes positive energy eigenvalues. 3c and 3d are significant. We only need to consider these two equations. Equation 3c becomes minus c p z u1. That term is 0. Minus c p minus u2 is 1. So it is 1. Plus e plus mc square into u3 equal to 0. So we will be getting u3 as c p minus by e plus mc square. Now equation 3d becomes, equation 3d becomes minus c p plus u1, u1 is 0, plus c p z u2 is 1, plus e plus mc square u4 equal to 0. From that calculate the value of u4 equal to minus c p z by e plus mc square. So the second solution we are obtaining as 0, 1, then u3 is c, p minus is px minus ipy by e plus mc square. Now fourth term u4 is minus c p z by e plus mc square. So this is the second solution. First solution is this one, second is this one. These two are solutions for positive energy eigenvalue. These two are solutions for positive energy eigenvalue. In a similar way, we will calculate the solutions for negative energy eigenvalue e minus. Now I calculate the solutions for negative energy eigenvalues e minus. When we take E minus, we are having acceptable solutions for equations 3C, 3A and 3B. 3Z and 3D, they are diverging for E minus energy eigenvalue. So for E minus energy eigenvalue, we will take equations 3a and 3b. For that, we will assume that U3, first case I am assuming as U3 equal to 1 and U4 equal to 0. U3 is 1 and U4 equal to 0. Therefore, equation 3a becomes equation 3a. 3a is E minus mc square U1. E minus mc square U1 minus cpz. U3 is 1. Now, minus U4 is 0. So, this term is 0, equal to 0. From that, calculate U1. U1 equal to cpz by E minus, this is E minus minus mc square, this is U1. Now equation 3b becomes, equation 3b, this one, this equation becomes E minus minus mc square U2, U2 is, U2 we have to determine, U2 minus c p plus U3 is 1, then plus cpz U4 is 0. So, 0 equal to 0. Now, find U2. U2 equal to Cp plus by E minus minus mc square. So, we got U1, U2, U3 and U4. So, that solution we can write it as, these two are for positive energy eigenvalues. Now, we will write the solution for negative energy eigenvalue. It is U1 is Cpz by E minus minus mc square. U2 is Cp plus. P plus is Px plus Ipy by E minus minus mc square. Now U3, U3 is 1, U4 is 0. So this is for negative energy eigenvalue. First solution for negative energy eigenvalue. Now we will determine the second solution for negative energy eigenvalue. For that we are assuming U3 equal to 0 and U4 equal to 1. U3 is taken as 0 and U4 is taken as 1. Then equation 3a becomes equation 3a. From 3a, this equation E minus mc square, this is E minus minus mc square U1 minus, this term becomes 0, minus Cp minus U4 equal to 0. U4 is 1. So, it's equal to 0. Then U1, what is U1? Cp minus, taking this to right hand side, Cp minus by E minus minus mc square. This is U1. Now, from equation 3b, find the value of U2. From equation 3b, E minus mc square U2 minus Cp plus U3 is 0. So, need not take that term. Minus 0, then plus Cpz U4 is 1 is equal to 0. From that, U2 equal to minus Cpz by E minus minus mc square. So, we have determined the fourth solution. The fourth solution we can write the fourth solution as, for E minus value we can write the fourth solution as U1 is Cp minus, P minus is Px minus Ipy by E minus minus mc square. Second term is U2, U2 is minus Cpz by E minus minus mc square. Now, U3 is 0, U4 is 1. So, these are the four solutions for free particle. Uj, one value, U1, U2, U3, U4. This is U1, U2, U3, U4. We are getting four independent solutions for the free particle. Dirac equation, 2 for E plus value and 2 for E minus value. From this positive energy eigenvalue, when P tends to 0, when you decrease the velocity, then it becomes non-relativistic case. So, when you decrease the velocity, when P tends to 0, this E plus approximately equal to mc square. if E plus approximately equal to mc square, P is much less compared to mc square. So this denominator becomes 2mc square. It is much high compared to PZ. So these terms reduces to 0. This is negligibly small. This also becomes negligibly small. So when we decrease the velocity, the last two terms in positive energy eigenvalue decreases and becomes 0. So the first two in positive energy eigenvalues, this first two terms, this 1, 0 and 0, 1, these first two terms, they are called strong components. Strong components. And the last two terms, they are called weak components. So we are having two strong components and two weak components. For positive energy eigenvalue, the first two components are strong components, because when we change the velocity of particle, there is no change in the first two components, but second two components, they decreases and become 0 when P equal to 0, when velocity becomes 0, or it is much less compared to velocity of light. That means in non-relativistic case, these solutions we can write for non-relativistic case. 1, 0, these two become 0. Second one, we can write it as, second one, 0, 1, 0, 0 in non-relativistic case. The third solution in non-relativistic case, we can write it as 0, 0, 1, 0. The fourth solution in non-relativistic case, we can write it as 0, 0, 0, 1. So these are the solutions U1, U2, U3, U4, the four components U1, U2, U3, U4. These two are for positive energy eigenvalues and these two are for negative energy eigenvalues. These four solutions represents the non-relativistic, the solutions for non-relativistic case. In relativistic case, these are the four solutions. Two corresponds to positive energy eigenvalue and two corresponds to negative energy eigenvalue. And out of these components, the first two components are called strong components and the second two components are called weak components. So these are the solutions of Dirac wave equation for a free particle. Thank you.